Hey everyone, it's Darren. Welcome. Today's video, we're going to just talk about Boolean values and Boolean functions. A lot of people never even realize they're using Booleans when they are using them. If you've ever used an if function, for example, if x equals 2, then do something. That's a Boolean function. The x equals 2 equates to a Boolean. Equals, greater than, less than, those are all Booleans. So what is a Boolean value, first of all? Boolean value are these things over here. It's true and false. That's all you've got to Boolean values. That's the basic functions behind a computer. It's ones and zeros. Logic statements equate to Boolean values. So what are the basic functions that use Booleans? And there's a few of them. The first one is and in its most basic form, and is just and then two values, a1, a2, and it's true. You can add more values to this. One, you can actually have one if you want. You can have and true, but that's doesn't get you much. So if you have and a1, a2, a3, that one's false. And the reason it's false is if you look here, true and true and false. Okay, well, that's false. Okay, well, what is the next common one that we use, which is or? So equals or. Syntax is the same thing. Or A1, A2 is true, because true or true is true. What if we put A3 on this one? True or false? Well, it's still true. In fact, the only way to get or to be false, just like and, everything has to be true, or anything has to be true. So if we did or A3, A6, because A6 down there is also false. Excuse me, or that would A3, A6. So the only way to make or false is that all of the parameters have to be false. Whereas and is false if any of the parameters is false. Okay, those are probably the two most common functions you're going to use. There's another one out there, which is XOR. And XOR, let's take a look at that. It stands for exclusive OR. So if we do XOR A2, A3, is true. Why is it true? Because A2 and A3, it says that exclusive OR, true, false. It's come out, turns out to true. Okay, well, what if we did A2 and A1? And that's false. So exclusive OR, so false, exclusive OR, false is false. False ex or true, exclusive OR, true is also false. You need to have exactly one item has to be true in this, and they can't all be true and they can't all be false. So that's exclusive OR. Now we also have a not function because sometimes you need to flip something around. So not only has one parameter. Not true is false, and not false is true. And you can actually apply those to these, so you can do things like not and, and remember that came out, that and function calculated to false. So not and is true. And Sometimes you'll hear that as NAND. You can do it with not and OR, which will give you the NOR function. You can do not XOR. I'm not sure why you'd want to, but you can. So those are basically the functions, and these can get chained in really complex ways. So, if you want to do equals OR of A1, OR of AND of A1, A2, and A3, A4 is true. And you can come in here and look at what this is telling you. This is saying, okay, so I'm going to start off by ANDing A1 and A2. So true and true. Well, that one's true. That's good. And ANDing A3, A4 is false and true. That one's false. So OR of true and false. And that one comes out to true. So you can chain these as much as you want. Often you don't look at them exactly so much like this. You look at them more in the context of parameters inside of an if statement, for example. That's fairly common. You might stick an if statement inside of other statements to get to your Booleans. But the Booleans are all the same. So now, how do you create these true and false things? Well, let's look. So if you want true, you can type true. Want false? Type false. Those are Booleans. Those aren't strings. So you can also do equations to give yourself a Boolean value. For example, I can do if 7 equals 5, then true. And since 7 does not equal 5, it gives me false. If it did equal true, it'd give me true. You don't have to just use equals there. You can use greater than, less than. So there's greater than is true, obviously. You can do less than. And one other one that you can do is actually not equals, which is less than greater than. And that is not equals. Couple of extra things that you can do with text strings. So let's say I want to compare zero and test. Okay, so if I want to compare a number to a text string, which often you won't need to do, but sometimes it'll inadvertently happen. So if I do if A11 is less than A12. Then less, else, greater. Now you see zero is less than test. As it happens, numbers, all numbers, no matter how big or small, are less than all text, no matter how big or small. Now there's two functions that you can do on text to compare text strings. So if I do equals if A12 equals A13, same. Else, different. So those are the same. They don't look the same to me. The reason that they're the same is that the equals function, when working with text strings, the equals function is not case sensitive. So they come out looking the same. Now, if you want case sensitive, there's another function that you have to use, which is exact. So if I could do exact A12, A13, that shows that it's false. And then you could do a something like if exact A12. In fact, let's go ahead and do that. So if exact A12, A13, then is same different. So you see here that you can see that they're different because we use the exact function. Although exact, you have to put it inside of an if you want to actually output strings. So those are the couple of quirks that are out there for text comparisons. So really that's about it for Booleans. And you can stick those into the greater than, the less than, the equals, the not equals, ands, ors, nots, all of that. Usually all of that winds up going inside of something like an if statement, which then may go into other things in order to make decisions of what you output. But that's about all there is really to Boolean functions, to Boolean operations in Excel. If you learned anything from this video, please click the like button and also be sure to subscribe and hit notify so you can see when new videos come out. I also have a Patreon page at patreon.com/dataanalysisexcellence. If you could help out the channel that way, that would be great. And hope you have a great day. I'll see you next time.